All right, welcome back to the Crypto ZX channel, to the XRP community. If you are enjoying these updates, smash that like button. And, you know, shout out to the XRP community for, you know, showing tremendous amount of love on the XRP updates. You know, I love each and every one of you guys. Continue supporting and you will see the continuation of these updates. So as we are pretty much halfway through the day of Wednesday, you are seeing a little bit of a retracement within the crypto space. You are seeing Bitcoin down about 2.5% and altcoins definitely being impacted right now. Pretty much everything right now is down, you know, over the course of the last 24 hours. As far as XRP is concerned, some interesting things happening, which of course are worthwhile noting. Price of XRP is currently sitting at almost 52.6 cents. Down about 1% in USD compared, but we're up 1.4% in Bitcoin comparative. Market cap is around almost 30 billion, to be exact, 29.8 billion, and the 24-hour trading volume is at about $1 billion. But before we get into it, as always, just a quick disclaimer, anything on this channel is not financial advice. Always do your own due diligence and research when you are investing in crypto. So shout out to Crypto Inside UK stating, interestingly, as the market pulls back, XRP holds strength, gains on market share. So if you're looking at it from the Bitcoin comparative or the Ethereum comparative, you're actually seeing XRP holding much better despite what we're seeing right now across the board. You know, multiple coins actually down about 5 to 6%. So, you know, in terms of strength, that's definitely being felt right now for XRP. So what could really be bringing strength within the price of XRP right now? Obviously, it's not seeing explosions. And, you know, there's no, you know, doubts about that. There's no, obviously, big moves. But the way it's currently holding is obviously having people, you know, talk about what could be the main cause of the price holding so well. Obviously, could that be due to a massive announcement that came out about the ETF, which, again, is confirmed. It's not like a speculation. It has been confirmed from Canary Capital, which is absolutely crazy to think about. And as I've said, I think as we go a little bit more into the future, we might start to see, as regulation is pretty much at the forefront of importance for, you know, major countries, and as, you know, regulation is coming towards the crypto industry, I think the coins or projects that have the regulatory compliance and that show the importance of regulation, I think those are the ones that are going to start seeing that snowball effect of ETFs coming. And, you know, people don't understand the importance of ETF. ETF makes it super easy for people to have exposure in crypto. And, you know, the likes of XRP would not be surprised now. The fact that you second ETF filing has already happened, I think this could be huge if we start seeing more and more piling up. So, again, not a surprise factor. And, of course, Ripple Swell event is coming up. You know, RLUSD potential launch could be coming very near. And BRICS summit is coming up. And, you know, all these things have a lot of people talking. And, again, we're still in quarter four. People tend to forget that as far as price action is concerned, people think that, you know, 2021 did not happen. People completely forget about that part. At that time, you know, the bull market, we still reached $2 price point for XRP. And at that time, we did not have good developments coming out of this SEC case. There were pretty much dry, I would say. And now, you know, since then, we have seen major developments. You know, the biggest one is XRP from the judge, you know, has been stated that it's not a security. And, you know, last time, while the case was pretty hot, we still made our way up to $2 in that bull cycle. So, you know, a lot of people are, you know, obviously considering that factor as well, especially the regulation side of things. But let me know in the comments down below what you guys think. And on top of that, Bitwise CIO says Bitcoin could go up to $80,000 in quarter four if Republicans win. And again, obviously, right now, we're going to see what happens. Elections are coming up in about a month. A lot of people are, you know, worried. And what I mean by worried are people are like, if it goes the other way, because right now the sentiment, you know, speak about the sentiment. In terms of sentiment, people think if Donald Trump does not win, you know, the market is going to crash. And is that going to happen? We'll see. Obviously, you know, there's no secret that Donald Trump has been quite clear about his statement regarding, hey, you know what, he wants to make, US the crypto hub. He does not want other countries, to become the crypto hub. He wants the United States of America to really become that major, crypto hub. And obviously, if that happens, it's no secret why, people are having a conversation revolving around, if Bitcoin will move up if that does happen. But again, there's still a chance that it could go other way around. So, we don't know. It's 50-50 at this point. And speaking about 50-50, believe it or not, even though the month of October is been bullish, it started bullish over the last 2 to 3 days. But with that said, people are still going to be sidelined, not knowing what's going to happen. So keep that factor in mind. And speaking about making US the crypto hub, we have heard some more announcements coming out of the BRICS. So after BRICS, new alliance has kickstarted the de-dollarization process and using the local currencies for trade and not the US dollar, the Commonwealth of Independent States, CIS, which consists of 12 countries, has settled 85% of cross-border transactions in national currencies. The CIS bloc barely used the US dollar for the trade settlements this year, ushering into a new financial landscape. And this could really tell you, how crazy this really is. A BRICS member, Russia, convinced the CIS bloc to begin using national currencies for trade and not the US dollar. The other existing member agreed to the trade policies put forward by Russia, as using local currencies will only strengthen their native economies. And this is what Vladimir Putin has to say: the use of national currencies and widening in mutual payments. Their share in commercial operations among CIS partner has already been above 85%. Putin revealed at the summit of BRICS and CIS will work towards ending the dependency on the US dollar forever. The process of important phase out is moving quickly, and thus the technology sovereignty of our country is being strengthened. The development will promote regional economic collaboration and deliver higher financial independence for developing countries. While the de-dollarization agenda was specific to BRICS, it is now being spread to the CIS alliance. So pretty much more countries are, pretty much wanting to, go with this de-dollarization agenda. The US dollar might find no takers if the development countries, leading to massive deficits and hyperinflation in homeland. Very, very crazy times we're living in, guys. Let me know where you think the stablecoin industry can come and change the game. And what are your personal projections if the likes of, Donald Trump or Kamala Harris, depending on who wins, do you think, they can come in and change this, de-dollarization thing that's really taking place? Or do you think this is a major, major concern? Let me know in the comments down below what your personal thoughts are. Looking at Bitcoin dominance, you're looking at Bitcoin dominance did wick down to 57.7%. So dominance actually went lower. But Bitcoin, on the other hand, also went lower right now. So you want to be thanking dominance for dropping, because if dominance went up, I think altcoins would have seen a worse day. Bitcoin actually made its way down to $60,370. A lot of manipulation, of course, is occurring, and a lot of uncertainty. Believe it or not, a lot of uncertainty. People are not, 100% certain as to which way the election is going to go, the person that is favoring crypto or the person that is not favoring crypto. And that, kind of keeps people on the sideline. And I think, honestly, even though October is what people talk about, I think we might see a lot of shaky moves happening this month, leading up to the election. And if the person that is rooting for crypto ends up winning, and again, this is just my own personal opinion, only time is going to tell, we potentially could see a super cycle, depending on what kind of, rules and regulation, they bring towards, the crypto industry. And speaking about the crypto industry, we're seeing regulation coming in. So like I said, the next, I would say, 3 to 4 weeks are extremely important for the entire crypto space. But yeah, as far as XRP price is concerned, it has been holding much better. And despite that appeal, you still have not seen the price of XRP reaching the July 8th price point. And again, if you want to put that into perspective, that's an additional move down 30%. So we got to keep these factors in mind. But let me know in the comments down below what you guys think right now and what are your personal projections. I love each and every one of you guys. Thank you for all your support. We'll see you tomorrow in CryptoZX, and peace out.